While we've been seeing a lot of rain on the ground, weather chasers got a look at it from high above today.
KCR3's own meteorologist Tamara Berg got a chance to join the scientists studying what they call the atmospheric river. And Tamara shows us their goal was to show the impact on the ocean.
Today, I got to embark on an exciting journey that not many meteorologists get to do. I was chosen to fly in a P-3 aircraft, which is known as a hurricane hunter. I flew in a plane basically that flew through Hurricane Katrina. Now, in doing this, we gathered some research and data on the impact of atmospheric rivers. As you know, we had the storm that moved through yesterday, and that was an atmospheric river setup. So it's basically a big hose of moisture that extends across the Pacific waters. And what we did today is we flew on the heels of that atmospheric river to gather data to see what the impact of that atmospheric river was on the ocean. So how did we do that? Well, we had a couple of pieces of tools of the trade here. This was one of them dropped in. This is a sono buoy. This was dropped in and it actually helped the meteorologists and the scientists on board measure relative humidity, temperature, wind speed, and direction. So today's mission was important, not only to be here on the West Coast, but these planes are going to be here for a couple of days examining and gathering the research for a big project called CalWater 2015. After the plane ride today, it was quite an experience as the scientists did debrief and we talked about the things that happened. So certainly some cutting edge technology, and it was a great flight today. I'm proud to say that I did earn my Hurricane Hunter wings and badge this afternoon.
Okay, so the P-3 Hurricane Hunter plane will fly into the storm again tomorrow. It'll be conducting more research over the next few days. Cool opportunity for her.
Yeah, nice behind the scenes look there. You forget the science that goes behind all this. All right.